Dear students, welcome to our class. Today we are going to start multiplication of vectors. First we'll discuss about a scalar product, and after that we'll go for vector product. So what scalar product is, agar hum do vectors ko multiply karenge us tarah se, so that agar inka product ek scalar quantity mil raha hai, we can call that product as a scalar product. Suppose if we have two vectors, say vector A and vector B. So it is a vector A and this is a vector B. Suppose there is some angle theta, their tails are joined here, and there is some angle theta between two vectors A and B. Then what we mean by scalar product? Scalar product will mention by this way, it is A dot B, that is magnitude of vector A multiplied by magnitude of vector B and the cos of angle theta between two vectors A and B. This A dot B we call as scalar, or we mention this product by dot product. We also call this as dot product. So A dot B is magnitude of A, magnitude of B, cos of angle theta, where this theta is the smaller angle between two vectors A and B. Yeah, we can write A dot B in simple ways, like it is A B cos of theta. Similarly, if we'll calculate B dot A, B dot A, that is equal to B A cos of theta. Or we can write B dot A is equal to B into A cos of theta. What this A cos of theta is here, I will explain that. Suppose you have the two vectors like vector A and vector B, they are making some angle theta between them. Suppose from this very point, if we will draw a perpendicular over here on vector B, then we can write here, this is A cos of theta. What this A cos of theta is, it is the scalar product of, sorry, it is the scalar component of vector A along the direction of vector B. This we call as a scalar component of vector A. So therefore B dot A can be written like B into A cos of theta. Similarly, we can write A dot B equal to A into B cos of theta, where this B cos of theta is the scalar component of B. It will be along the direction of vector A. So this is the way how we get scalar product of two vectors. So yaad rakho bacho, it is A dot B is equal to AB cos of theta, or we can write B dot A, it is equal to BA cos of theta. This B dot A equal to BA cos theta, it can be also written as A into B cos of theta. What we mean by these two points, that A dot B is always equal to B dot A. So this is the basic property of these, the scalar product, that A dot B equal to B dot A means scalar product is always commutative, means it obeys commutative law. So scalar product is commutative. Now we also know that if this angle theta between two vectors A and B, if angle theta between two vectors A and B is 0 degree, what will happen there? A dot B will be equal to A B cos of 0 degree, and that is A B cos 0 is 1, so it is A B. Means two vectors, if they are having the angle between them as 0 degree, means they are in the same direction, their angle is 0 degree, us time pe jo A dot B aayega, that will be equal to A dot B. However, if two vectors will have the angle theta as 180 degree, at that very time, A dot B, their scalar product is A B cos of 180 degree. What cos 180 is? It is minus 1. So it is minus times AB. Means if two vectors are anti-parallel or they are in the opposite directions, their angle is 180 and their dot product is minus AB. However, if we have two vectors like this, we have two vectors, one is vector A, second is vector B, their angle is here theta as 90 degree. At that very time, A dot B will be equal to AB cos of 90. What cos 90 is? It is 0. So it is AB into 0 and that is 0. So this is very important point that if two vectors are having angle between them as 90, their dot or scalar product is always 0. Now we have here two best examples of scalar product. One is work, second is power. Both can be expressed in terms of the scalar product. Like we have work here, it is expressed as the scalar product of force and displacement. And power is expressed as the scalar product of and dot product of force and velocity. So both work and power are scalar quantities, hence they are expressed in terms of their scalar product. Here we have scalar product of force and displacement, and here we have scalar product of force and velocity. As you have seen, what power is, it is rate of doing work, it's W by T. Work itself is force dot displacement divided by time. So you can write it as F dot S divided by T. So you can write, therefore, power P is equal to F is force, and what is S by T? S by T is displacement by time, and we call that as velocity. And its power can also be expressed in terms of the scalar product of two vectors, force and velocity. So both power and work are scalar quantities, and they can be expressed as the scalar product of vectors, like work in terms of force and displacement, and power in terms of force and velocity. These are the two best examples of scalar product. For more videos, subscribe our channel Farad Sir Physics. And press the bell icon to get the notifications.